Millions of gallons of Agent Orange and other herbicides were sprayed on trees and vegetation.
Thousands of American military members fighting in Vietnam were exposed to Agent Orange.
Many veterans wonder if they'd survived the battlefield only to return home as walking time bombs.
Few are better known than Agent Orange.
We sprayed Agent Orange around the perimeter of Cuba to eliminate enemy cover.
Planes came in low over the
Jacana.
Damage passed on from mothers to children.
And we do not believe that there is yet clear scientific evidence that shows a direct...
And who's caught in the middle here?
Arrived in Vietnam, the United States sprayed the area with Agent Orange.
During the Vietnam War, the U.S. military engaged in an aggressive program of chemical warfare codenamed Operation Ranch Hand. It lasted for about 10 years from 1961 to 1971. Over 20 million gallons of various chemicals are sprayed across more than 4.5 million acres of Vietnam to destroy the forest cover and food crops used by the enemy North Vietnamese and Viet Cong troops. And among those chemicals was Agent Orange. Agent Orange is only one of the series of heavy-duty chemicals that the US military used for chemical warfare in Southeast Asia, called Rainbow Herbicide. There were also chemicals like Agent Blue, Green, White, Purple, and Pink. But Agent Orange was the most destructive out of all of them. All of the agents in Rainbow Herbicide contains active ingredients that defoliate plants. However, they did not expect that TCDD, which is a type of dioxin, will be present in all of the agents. The dioxin was a byproduct that was produced during the manufacturing of the herbicides. TCDD was found in varying concentrations in all the different herbicides used in Operation Ranch Hand. But the dioxin found in Agent Orange is the most dangerous of all. So what are the effects of Agent Orange? Agent Orange is an equal mixture of two herbicides, both of which have been noted to be hazardous to the wildlife and fatal in human health. When they are combined, they produce a dangerous byproduct, dioxin TCDD, a highly persistent chemical compound that lasts for many years in the environment, and the most toxic of the dioxin family of chemicals. As the US military sprayed the chemical, it settled into humid areas like wetlands, marshes, or lakes. From there, it ended up ingested by fish and shrimp, accumulated inside their tissues, and moved up the food chain. The damage to the plant life of South Vietnam caused by the spraying of Agent Orange is still visible today. The most severe damage occurred in the mangrove forest of coastal areas, where it left badly eroded coastlines and lands that are no longer capable of producing any vegetation. As the rich, diverse tropical forests disappeared, so did animal habitats. As a result, the number of bird and mammal species living in the areas that were sprayed declined dramatically. Once the cover and food resources of the forest were removed, various species of deer and wild animals such as tiger, water buffalo, wild goat, and wild boar become less common. Domestic animals like pigs, chickens, and ducks were also reported to become ill after the spraying of Agent Orange. Dioxin accumulates in fatty tissue in the bodies of fish, birds, and other animals. Most human exposure is through food such as meats, poultry, dairy products, eggs, shellfish, and fish. Short-term exposure to dioxin can cause darkening of the skin, liver problems, and a severe acne-like skin disease called chloracne. Studies done on laboratory animals have also proven that dioxin is highly toxic, even in minute doses. It is universally known to be a carcinogen, a cancer-causing agent. Additionally, dioxin is linked to type 2 diabetes, immune system dysfunction, nerve disorders, muscular dysfunction, hormone disruption, and heart disease. Developing fetuses are particularly sensitive to dioxin, which is also linked to miscarriages, spina bifida, and other problems with fetal brain and nervous system development.
The estimated cost of damage after the Vietnam's Agent Orange was over $300 million. $100 million was invested for the cleanup process of the contaminated sites in Vietnam, and over $200 million was devoted for the healthcare treatment of the people affected in Vietnam.
In the year 1979, a class action lawsuit was filed on behalf of 2.4 million veterans that were exposed to Agent Orange during their service in Vietnam. 6 years later, seven large chemical companies that manufactured the herbicides agreed to pay $180 million in compensation to the veterans or to their next family or kin. In 1991, President George H.W. Bush signed into law the Agent Orange Act.
Signed into law two bills which give veterans and their families the compensation that they deserve. The first is H.R. 3, concerning the effects on veterans of exposure to herbicides used during the Vietnam War.
As the result
this
of
is a continuation
service
of our policy over the past 2 years.
Till this day, dozens of contaminated areas still continues to contaminate the food, soil, livestock, and wildlife with Agent Orange. Agent Orange continues to negatively affect the people's lives. It is also the root cause of the disabilities, diseases, and pain. Often it is untreated and unrecognized.
In 1998, the Vietnam Red Cross established the Vietnam Agent Orange Victims Fund to provide direct assistance to families throughout Vietnam that have been affected. In 2003, the Vietnam Association of Victims of Agent Orange, or VAVA, was formed. In addition to filing the lawsuit against the chemical companies, VAVA provides medical care, rehabilitation services, and financial assistance to those injured by Agent Orange.
She believes many of the children in them have been affected by Agent Orange, a defoliant dropped by US forces.
Vietnamese have established peace villages that caters 50 to 100 victims, giving them medical and psychological help. Even though the Vietnam War had ended on the 30th of April 1975, its devastating effects are still evident years later. The Vietnam government stated that because of Agent Orange, generation upon generation of Vietnamese citizens are still susceptible to its disastrous aftermath. The country's wildlife and environment had also dealt with the consequences, with more than 4.5 millions of acres of trees in the forest lost its vegetation due to the biological weapon. Up until today, the Vietnamese has permanent scars etched in their hearts, souls, and mind. No one can relieve them of their suffering, and all the money in the world cannot change their fate. This is the Vietnamese toxic legacy.
Thank you. nằm nghe sóng vỗ từng.